Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Theopolis. In this episode, we get started with thermal theories when making an induction smelter for making a diamond mesh. We also set up a basic system of auto sieving and a blast chiller for ice, which we used for making ourselves a netherrack generator. So, I hope you enjoy. Alright, so today we are going to work on making some simple machinery and trying to get ourselves a diamond mesh for our heavy sieve. To do that, there's a lot of stuff we need to prepare and get ready. We need to start by making power, because we can't run the machines without power, and the only way to make power at the moment, which is what the quest tells me to do, is down here under... Is it in here? Flint mesh? I can't remember where it is. Is it under iron sieving? I'm actually forgetting where it was. But it's in here somewhere. Maybe it's up here? I don't know, but it tells me to make... Oh no, it's basic automation. There we go. A pitiful generator. Pitiful generator is a logistical sorter, some cinnabar, 4 furnaces, and 2 blast furnaces. So, furnaces, not the problem. I've already got 16 of them ready. I've also need to make myself some more crucibles, because a crucible is required for making ourselves our blast furnaces. I've got barrels, I've got some fired crucibles. I should have a fair bit of porcelain in here. And yeah, so now we can just make ourselves 3 more of these. And you know what? I'm actually going to make a few blast furnaces. Why not? Put those in there to start smelting. So, our objective really is, I already said, basic machinery and a diamond sieve, is also to set up a netherrack generator. I need netherrack for glowstone to be able to make more of this glass, which I have been preparing in here, and it's nearly got a full chest, and this guy is still half full. So I want to change out all of these leaves by next episode. So next episode, you will see a completely different area, no more leaves, and the entire ceiling will be filled in, because I've just added an elevator here to allow us to go up, because I'm going to be setting up things up here then as well as soon as we have unlocked that scale. So these fire crucibles should be about ready. That's enough of them. So a blast furnace then. If I go over here and click this. So I need compressed cobblestone, which I do have. And there we go. So now we can make ourselves our 2 blast furnaces. And then we can make ourselves a pitiful generator. I just need cinnabar, which I should have some in here. Yep. And I'm also going to need ourselves a logistical sorter. So that requires a logistical pipe. It's going to require some constantin. And bronze, which I have prepared a little bit more. So I should have plenty of that now. So logistical sorter. There we go. And you know what? We're actually going to need another 4 of these. Because 4 is going to be used in making the auto sieves and the auto hammer. The auto hammer is actually kind of useless, because we can't hammer down certain things. Yeah, it might be good if we want to set up using andesite and diorite and grand for auto hammering down into our dust version for making lava. That's a good way to use this. You know what, actually, maybe we should use it for that. We'll see. But the auto sieve is definitely something you'll want to get, because starting to sieve all the overworld matter and some sand and stuff that we get, and especially the netherrack, is definitely a must. So, we need basically a universal cable to actually transfer power around and make the pitiful generator. There we go. Now what we have to do is make the auto sieve, which requires glass and an actual sieve. And you know what? I actually have a sieve over here that's not being used, because I took the mesh out to upgrade it for the heavy sieve. So this guy is doing nothing, so we'll upgrade him. I'm also going to need myself a hammer, a compressed hammer. I don't think I have a stone one. I have an iron one, but not a stone one. So just grab some sticks, and I'm going to grab myself some granite. Put these in here, and I should be able to make 9 of these. So 1, 2, 8, and 9. Put these in my inventory, and make ourselves a compressed hammer. Right, so all I have to do now is just get out some glass. So auto hammer, and then auto sieve. Perfect. And that's that chapter complete. So I can put the pipe away for now. And grab me ammo I can figure. Actually, no. Give me the pipe and the mechanical pipe. I'm probably going to need them. I can put this away and this away with this. And put this stuff away in here. Because I did actually ended up sorting out everything. So mob drops, I've got random stuff, more random stuff. And then we got food, organic stuff, nitre and nitre from sieving. So much sand for making a lot of tin. And then in here is like tools and utilities. We've also got buckets of organic water, which we are going to use now next episode for creating some simple plants. Because I also want to set up a mob farm over there properly. Hence why I have all this stuff bookmarked. So all this stuff is sorted in here. So resources and then ores. So as you can see, I've been sieving quite a bit. And in terms of overworld matter, I have made so much that it's going to take a long time for us to actually get through this. Like, this is all compressed. And I'm making more right now. And there's still 1,000 blocks to go through. And I've already gone through all the prismarine. This is actually the second lot it's going through. So we'll have to go through the prismarine and make all the lanterns then as well. And if you haven't there's a lot of stuff I'm after doing. I'm after forgetting all of it now. But I have upgraded the smeltery a lot bigger. Which I did not explain at the start. But you can see I've done that. So we need to pick a location of where we're going to put this pitiful generator now. And since I'm going to be putting a blast chiller right there with the water, I think I should just put this in this corner here. And then hook the pipes off of it there. And then what we'll do is we'll put the auto sieve. Actually, I'm trying to figure out where to be the best place to put this. If I want, actually, I know what to do. I'll put this here with the auto sieve there. And if I go get myself some chests or barrels and some hoppers, I should be able to pump stuff out of it. No problem. So let's go over here and see if we can get this guy set up to start sieving up some organic matter. So if I do this and then do this and give him a stack of organic matter, and I'll grab my mesh out of here, my iron one, and then give him the iron mesh and give him a stack of this, and I'll grab another stack. So it's going to completely use up two stacks of overworld matter. And now I actually have to get some coal to fill that up. So what I'm actually going to do is, I'm going to put it on the top there, but that's not going to work with this here. Actually, you know what? It will. I just need to move this to the side. So that there, this here, and then boom, that will work. Now let me just get some coal. Stack of charcoal should do. I could also use up this wood. Like, I have so much wood here. Like, it's actually kind of ridiculous. So charcoal in there, that will start generating up a bit of power. This guy will slowly work because he requires 40 Fe a tick, where this thing only produces 30. And I can't upgrade it. So he's just going to slowly work away and just generate us materials. Actually, you know what? He's actually already done one. So cool. So let's go to work on making the next couple of things because we need to make this induction smelter now. So to make this induction smelter, we need a machine frame, which requires us to make electrum and a bronze gear and iron plates. So electrum is pretty simple. It is a one-to-one recipe with gold. So if I was to do 8 gold blocks with, I don't know, 8 silver blocks, that will make us 16 blocks of electrum, which should be perfect for what we want to do. There's like a visual bug where like you have to like exit the thing and go back in to actually see the progress bar going up. Kind of weird. But now we also need to make ourselves some invar, because invar is going to be needed for the gears for making most machines. And invar is a 2-to-1 recipe of 2 iron to 1 nickel. So let's say we want to make ourselves, I don't know, we'll do the same thing. So we'll do ourselves 8 nickel blocks. And we'll do ourselves 16 iron blocks. Here we go. This should be plenty. And I'm actually trying to figure out what the conversion rate. I think you get 3 per thing. But you can see we got plenty of electrum. And it should make 16 in total. Which it has. Now I want to turn this off for just a moment. Because it's no longer needed. So if we grab our electrum and come over here. Oh wait, we actually need to make some casts. I actually forgot about that. So we need 2 gold and I'm going to need some wood. So there's actually a wooden plate that you can make to be able to make this plate gold cast. So the plate requires 2 oak logs, and then I'm going to need a gear, which is 4 planks. So we'll just make ourselves a gear, and then we have a wooden plate. And we come over here to our smeltery, and we'll cast ourselves out these casts. I need to melt down this gold first, and then we should be good to go. All right, the 2 gold's done. Come over here and take out the ingot cast, pour our gold on top of that. And then the same thing for the plate. And then over here, we need to decide what we have first. So we have Electrum, so we want plates being casted at that. Let me just pick that up for the quest. Break this lever, because we're going to need to probably cast out a good few of these. So now we can see, once we have done this, we can actually, we're going to need more iron now as well. So actually, how many Invar blocks does that make? 24. Interesting. So, more iron, and since we're going to need plenty of iron plates, actually, let's count how many we're going to need. So iron plates, we need 4... 8, 12 in total. And we're going to need Invar plates here and an Electrum gear. We don't need any iron here. We need blocks of iron. So if we need 8, then we might as well just break down a block. But I think I might want to make a little bit more than just that. So you know what? Actually, I'm going to smelt down 4 blocks of iron and turn all of those into plates. So the process now is pretty much just waiting for all this Electrum plates to get smelted down. You know what? I'm actually going to change it to iron now. Actually, you can't do iron just yet. Let me make the Invar gears then while we're waiting. So let that finish. And you know what? We actually do need an Electrum gear. So we'll make that quickly. And now let's change... Sure, we'll take it a block. We might actually need some ingots. I did not mean to hit that lever. Yeah, you can see now the ingots all over the place. But there we go. We got the iron. So... Actually, we want to do the Invar first. So we'll do some Invar gears. So we'll take these out. There we go. Right, I'm going to let iron plates start smelting out. And we're going to go over here now and do a little of this few quests that are left. There's a few things that we need to do to complete one other chapter, which is the Iron Sieving chapter. It's only a few things. So in here, we need to make ourselves a calculator, a solar cooker, a reflector, and grab ourselves the Electrum. And you know what? That Electrum block we poured out will actually do perfect for making this achievement. So we actually have everything we need now to make this block. Hang on, can I make it right now? Oh, we need bronze gears and Constantine gears. So I actually need to smelt down a few of those things. I forgot about that. So let's see. So we got ourselves Constantine block. I'm going to smelt down 2 of those and 2 bronze blocks. Let's get those smelting up. And we also need to make ourselves a anvil from Tinkers, which requires a load of the bronze that we have. So let's go in here and grab this. And we'll make ourselves our anvil. There we go. What else is left in that quest? A seared shoot. What the hell is a seared suit? Shoot. Don't know what it is, but it seems like it is needed. So we'll make one quickly. So, brick, seared drain. Actually, it's the same recipe as this. It's just opposite. There we go. I have no idea what that does, but whatever, it was part of a quest. Does it actually say smeltery item input and output? Oh, wait, we can actually use this as automation then. Ah, okay, I see. Right, our bronze and Constantine should be melted down right now, so we need to pour ourselves out 2 gears of this and 2 gears of bronze. So in terms of making... What is it? The crafting calculator. We need stone, iron, and some redstone. So let's go do that. There we go. That's stone. So now we can go in here and turn our ink sack into some dye. Apparently I already have redstone in that chest, which is actually the wrong chest. So crafting calculator, like so. And now we just need a little bit of wood because we need to make ourselves a quick chest. Like so. And now we can go ahead and make our solar cooker. And we're going to need 4 reflectors. There we go. That's that one done. And I've already got that one. So what's left? Oh, yes. We need this base upgrade. Pretty sure that is a string leather and a piece of iron. There we go. And there's the Iron Sieving chapter complete. We got a ton of rewards there. We got ourselves 26 C-Bucks. Nice. So if we head back over here, our Constantine gear should be casted out. I need to do one more. And then we have to do 2 bronze. This chest is completely full. So you are no longer going... Oh, you'll complete a one more buffer and that'll be it. Right, I need to empty out my inventory because it is currently full of random junk. Right, now we can switch out to our bronze and cast out two of those. And for the Constantine, I think that we needed that for our blast chiller or... Actually, wait, which one do we need it for? Oh, it's for this guy. And the actual casing is the bronze gear. Right, right, right. Okay, so we actually need four of these gears. So we've got one now. I need to go get myself some glass and some iron. Because I forgot to take that out with me. So iron and some glass. Now we can make ourselves our machine frame. We need to make a second one, but we need more iron plates. Which we should have enough of. Did I not cast out enough? Oh yeah, I did. Plenty of them. Alright, so another machine casing. And can I make one more? I just need the last bronze gear, which is casting right there behind me. So, induction smelter. We need a blast furnace, two sand, and a redstone block. Right, we should have everything for it now. So, induction smelter. And perfect. So, blast chiller now requires a redstone flux coil. Now, this is made by red alloy and molten gold. The red alloy is four redstone and then one of each, either iron and copper. So, say we are going to make ourselves, let's grab out two sacks, or two redstone blocks. And we get ourselves out, let's say, actually, yeah, 18 is good. That we just need, means we need six iron. I think this is right. So, six iron and then six copper. That should equal out. Yeah, because it's a one-to-one, so hopefully this is right. I'm hoping I have no idea if I'm doing this math right. But anyway, we can put the induction smelter down over here with our power. This guy should slowly fill up a power, but now we can just chuck these in here. This will start making us red alloy. We have to then put more gold in here because we definitely do not have enough gold. So I need to cast out probably more bronze gears and more iron plates and whatnot. So we actually need to cast out four Invar plates because it is something that we are going to need. And I'm actually going to pour a little bit of Invar there now. Oh, yeah, there's always, I'm always hearing these things. I'm always terrified. But this is now made red alloy and we only needed two pieces. And I think it is now two gold per one. So if we have four, we're going to need eight gold to be able to turn all of these in. But the worst part about this now is we actually need 16 of these things because the diamond mesh requires 16 redstone flux coils and a redstone servo, which is a diamond gear. So we need to make ourselves four diamonds. We might be thinking, how do we get diamonds? We need a diamond mesh to get diamonds. Like if we look in here at diamond, diamond requires a diamond mesh and compressed overworld matter to get it. Turns out you actually use a multi-servo press with half a stack of coal, and that makes a diamond. So we need to do that. So gold can go in there, start melting down. Oh, hasn't actually rained in a while. It's actually kind of annoying now because I don't have a roof to muffle it out. Just waiting for this gold to finish melting, put it there. And now we just grab our red alloy. And you just put it in here and cast the gold on top of it. And this will make yourself a redstone flux coil. Just need two of those. But if I can get just one right now, I should be able to go ahead and make myself my multi-servo. I need two bronze and a block of iron. And now I can also make this one. So I should have everything. So let's head back over in here out of the rain. And what do we need? I need the two compressed in here, so that's good. So, blast chiller, done. Multi-servo, I need another machine casing. Oh yeah, I was waiting for that one to cast out. My bronze gear is over here. Okay, there we go. Now we can make ourselves another machine casing. And then we can go ahead and make our multi-servo press. So now we've got these two. The blast chiller is going to be used to make us obsidian and blue ice. Where the multi-servo is going to make us our diamond. So, let's uncompress this. And there we go. We need four stacks of coal to make four diamonds. So multi-servo press, I'm going to put you down right here. And I'm going to put my blast chiller here instead. So I'm going to break this and put this down right here. So this will accept water in the top, like so. And make sure everything stays lit up. that correct? Okay, good. So you are going to fill up, but I need to give it power now. So either I run the power cable underneath, which is most likely what I need to do. Yeah, I've only got two of these spruce planks left. I don't know what happened to my chisel. I know I definitely didn't use it up, but my chisel is gone. So I don't know what happened. But I can't make another one because I need orange dye. So that's a rip. And there goes my axe, but just in time. Right, this is going to be sketchy, but I have a trapdoor over there, so let's jump in. Yeah, they're all over there. All right, we should be fine. Bring this out and around and up here. Oh damn, they're right there. I can swim up and around, it's fine. There we go. Now we can fill this in and the cables are completely hidden. So this guy will start generating ice and we need 9 ice to make 1 packed ice and then a 9 packed ice to make 1 blue ice. So we need a total of 36 ice to be able to make 1 blue ice. No, I'm thinking, no. No, that's only going to make us 4 packed ice. We need a lot of ice. So I'm just going to let that go. And you know what? Just output into the chest here. So auto output. I don't need to auto input, just auto output, please. All right, perfect. So this guy, power cave on top, coal inside, and you're not getting any power. Probably because all the power is currently going into these things. So I'm actually going to disconnect this for now because I don't need it. And there we go. Now it's working, but it's going to take absolutely forever to do anything. Maybe I should make a second one. Okay, I've disabled this guy because he has to fill up a power first because this guy is getting absolutely no power at all. So we'll just have to leave it go. So let's try and work on making enough of these redstone flux coils for the diamond mesh. And we can't do anything until we've got our blue ice for the netherrack. Also, once we make the diamond mesh, we can actually upgrade straight to an emerald one as soon as we get 8 osmium blocks, which won't be difficult with the compressed overworld matter. And because of the emerald we got over in the Leviathan, we have 39. That is more than enough for one block. So I think once we make this one and get our 8 osmium, I'm going to go straight into getting this emerald mesh, which we'll have by next episode if we set up now. So I'm going to quickly go and make everything we need now for this diamond mesh. All right, there we go. We have 16 redstone flux coils. We've got our 4 diamonds now. So to make this thing now, the redstone servo, we need to put it in there in the this guy, which I've already gone ahead and made the gear working die because I need to make a gold gear because I also made an upgrade, a hardened integral upgrade. And it's actually not that expensive for Inverglass redstone and gold gear. So put the 4 diamonds in there. This will make ourselves a diamond gear. And now I have to put this in here. I have to get my diamond or my iron mesh. Put the iron mesh in here now. And then grab our diamond gear. And then surround it with iron and alloy. And I don't have enough iron. So I need to go get a little bit more. So 2 more iron. And then we can make ourselves a redstone servo. And I can put all these away because I don't need them. And now we can finally make our diamond mesh. This requires a total of 100,000 RF, which this thing is completely full with. So by the time this thing is empty, we should have our diamond mesh. Now, on the other hand, this guy is making us ice still, and we have 38. So if we come over here, and how much does this make? This has made us 4 packed ice. So 2 sets of 36, which is 72. We need 72 ice to be able to make ourselves a blue ice. So I'm just going to let this guy run and it should be good. And you know what? Let's actually crush up all this prismarine that we have while we're waiting. I'm probably going to need to make myself another hammer because I've also gone through another full barrel. So I've actually got 3 stacks of compressed prismarine in here. So I'm going to go ahead and make myself another iron hammer. Just need a little bit more iron. And there we go. So let's break it all. And we should be able to get ourselves our 32 sea lanterns from all this. Like, there's no reason why we shouldn't have enough. Damn, that actually went through like an entire hammer's worth. Right, so come over here. Look up sea lantern. Craft that. And we just added Prismarine crystals now, but I'm sure we have enough here to make more. I'm actually going to use up quite a bit of this Prismarine here. You can actually, we can actually craft back in and then crush down back into shards again. I didn't actually know that. Okay, that's good. Pick it all back up and we're done. So those sea lanterns that we just made are going to be used for lighting up all the extra rooms that we have. That'll be good. Put all these in here and put these things away. How's our diamond mesh doing? Because if it's still only halfway done, oh, it's finished. So we have our diamond mesh now. So that unlocks our next tier sieving, which is actually, where does that unlock? Not actually entirely sure. Oh no, it unlocks in here. Okay, so now we have a way of being able to make blaze powder, apparently. Blaze comes from sieving soul sand. Right. Soul sand is something that we don't have access to just yet. We could do it right now, but I don't, do we actually have the time to do this? You know what, we might actually, yeah, we should. I need this thing to stop, but I just, there we go. I need this thing to disable and I need to break it, but I need this thing to stop inputting is the problem. So turn off the inputs and outputs, and I need to grab myself a bucket and some food. There we go, blue ice. What the hell is that noise? Can you hear that? It's like gas releasing. What? I don't know if you could hear that in the video, but it was just like, it was like sounds of like gas releasing from pneumatic craft. Weird, but apparently you can actually cook apples, which are a really good source of food, which I did not know until I pressed like use on apple. So you can actually cook apples into cooked apples, which, as you can see, 2 meat pops, 3 meat pops, and saturation is 1.5 to like 6, so it triples your food. But we're making a bucket quickly because we need to make some lava. So, if we grab our bucket and go over here and grab a bucket of lava, and then we come over to this blast chiller, break it. It's going to put water down everywhere, but that's fine. As long as no water goes in, it's okay. So, we put a bucket of lava in there and we enable it. That will make us an obsidian. And I'm going to actually grab another bucket and make 2 obsidian just in case. So, this will make us our obsidian. And we actually want to prepare over here now. So, I want to break this and break this. Actually, no, you know what? I could have left this here. I didn't actually need to break this. Put that back in. And what I need to do is grab myself my mechanical pipe and my configurator. And then what I need to do is break this block right here and come over here and grab my obsidian that I have now produced. There we go. Ice bucket. And what I need to do now is grab myself a stone barrel, which I should have one. I don't think I used them all up. Or did I? Maybe I did. Let me make a few more stone barrels. Okay. And now if we grab our stone barrel and our obsidian, put the obsidian right here, put the stone barrel there, grab our mechanical pipe and put it here, disconnect it there, and set this guy up also to extract. So whenever this pipe is full, it will extract it out into here instead. This lava will now turn into witch water when on top of obsidian. And I think I'd seen a bucket of that to complete a quest. And you know what? I'm going to hold onto a bucket because that will become useful for making our mob farm now next episode. So let's quickly make ourselves our netherite. Netherrack generator. So we just need ourselves another bucket. I need to grab myself a bucket of lava now. So if lava is there, so that means I want to put the blue ice there. And I want to put the smooth stone there. And I forgot to get the trap doors. All right, there we go. So I'm gonna put a trap door here and here. And this doesn't need it, but I want to just use it for the aesthetic. Nope, that is facing the wrong way. There we go. So now we just put the lava in here, and this should make us netherrack. Whoa. No, apparently not. Why aren't you... What the hell's going on with this lava? Is that not what I was supposed to do? Oh, wait. I completely forgot another step. I need to put a piece of soul soil in the ground right here. I completely forgot about that. We actually have to go make one. And break this up here. Put it down. And now when we put the bucket of lava in, this should make netherrack. There we go. Now we can do it. And you know what? I am going to quickly make another block breaker. So, 1 second. All right, there we go. I got it myself. Oh, I need to break this. Okay, yeah, that didn't break anything. Right, so block breaker right here. And that made ourselves a netherrack. Barrel on top. Set this guy to push. And there we go. I'm pretty sure that's everything that we needed done now. So, I just need to leave that netherrack built up, and then I can break it down and get it sieving and make some glowstone to be able to make the glass and swap everything out. Now, I think we said we were going to quickly make this into an emerald mesh, which required us to actually go ahead and make 8 osmium blocks, which I really want to do now, but it's really cutting it fine on the time. So, I'm just going to cut it, get the 8 osmium, put it in there, and then we'll end the video. All right, these are the last of the osmium we need now. So once they go over here into the chest, we should have ourselves 8 osmium. So all we need now is ourselves our diamond mesh and a block of emerald. So we'll go over here and grab our emeralds. We've actually gotten quite a bit of diamonds in the short bit of sifting I did to get this osmium. So emerald block. Usually you'll have to, how do you actually get emeralds otherwise? Emerald mesh or by... it doesn't actually say. But I'm sure there's a different way to get it, so... at least we got it. Unless the whole purpose of getting emerald is actually going over to the Leviathan over there. Because it used to be gold, but we got emerald out of it. So that might be a recipe change. But this will all go in here, and this is going to require... 500,000 RF, so it's definitely not going to be done this episode, but it will definitely be done by next episode. So I'm going to end it there. Hope you all enjoyed, and if you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe if you're new. Hope to see you all in the next episode. So without further ado, goodbye.